गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू, वेलकम टू लीगल मैटर्स बाय साई बाबू सुंकरा। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ केस जजमेंट डिलीवर्ड बाय द ऑनरेबल सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया इन विच इट वॉज वंस अगेन स्टेटेड दैट द पब्लिक ऑफिसर्स, द गवर्नमेंट ऑफिसर्स, द हायर ऑफिसर्स शुड नॉट बी कॉल्ड टू द कोर्ट इन ईच एंड एवरी केस, only in extraordinary circumstances or in exceptional cases only they have to be summoned, whenever needed their presence, then only they should be called. The dignity and majesty of the court will not enhance by calling the government officers, because they have got their own pre-engagements, they are doing public service. Normally, suppose if you call a DGP to the court, on that particular day, he might have to attend some function, he might have to attend some public meeting, or he might have to attend certain meeting with his officers. So many things are there, so many priorities will be there. So keeping them aside, he has to come to the court and he has to wait right from 10:30 to 5 p.m., which does not look good. Of course, if it is necessary, then you can summon them. But calling them frequently to the court, personal appearance, all these things, they don't seem to be good. This was reiterated by the two judges bench, Justice Hemant Gupta and V. Ramasubramanyam, while disposing the case of Pradhana UP Gramina Bank, just like our Andhra Pragati Gramina Bank, like that. Pradhana UP Gramina Bank versus Sunil Kumar. This citation can be seen in Live Law 2021 SEC 575, and while disposing the civil appeal number 6316 by 2021 on 8th October 2021, two judges bench deprecated the practice of summoning the public officers to the court unnecessarily. This is the main thing. So in this case, what happened is this Pradhana UP Gramina Bank, a daily wager, he filed a case against the bank against his termination. So the Allahabad High Court asked the presence of the chairman of the said bank and also the regional manager of the said bank, what for, to file an affidavit regarding how many daily workers are working in their branches in their bank. This is the information they want. Of course, since he filed a petition regarding the termination of his services, definitely how many are there, that can be known. But it can be known only when they file the affidavit, and when the Honorable Court sees the affidavit itself is sufficient. There is no purpose in calling the regional manager, in calling the chairman also. Suppose what is that both of them can do? Both of them can give only one reply. So instead of summoning them, so if the court poses a question and asks them to answer in the shape of affidavit, it is sufficient. It is not necessary to call them. So Supreme Court found no reason to call the chairman and regional manager of the said bank. Suppose if the High Court is sure that the termination is not according to procedure, definitely they can pass an order. If it is contrary to the law, they can pass an order for his reinstatement. But the summoning officers who are discharging their public duties is clearly unwarranted. Friends, remember previously in another case, that is the State of UP versus Manoj Kumar Sharma, I think 2021, SC 289. The Supreme Court already commented against summoning of the public officers. In that case, the Supreme Court said the public officers should not be called to court unnecessarily. They should not be called to the court without any reason. Dignity and majesty of the court does not enhance when an officer is called to the court. Of course, the public officers, they have got so many official engagements demanding attention, their priorities are different. So it is against the public interest. Calling of the public officers is against the public interest. So here the Supreme Court has beautifully written, please remember, courts have got the power of pen, which is more effective than the presence of the officer in the court. If you pass an order, definitely they will run from pillar to post to execute or to comply with order. Is it not? Why you call the officers unnecessarily? Having called them, it happened. One incident I want to tell you. It happened in Andhra Pradesh, AP High Court only. In the arrest case of arrest of the ex-CM Chandrababu Naidu in Vishakhapatnam, I think the DJP was called to the High Court, and the DJP, Mr. Gautam Sawang, he was asked to read section 151 CRPC. 151 CRPC, very such a simple section where the police officer, in order to prevent the commission of a cognizable crime, the police can arrest a person that is preventive detention, preventive arrest. So for that, he was asked to read, he was asked to explain how it will look. So can he, of course, can he show his face to the subordinates after the incident? So the subordinates may be under the impression that even the DG does not know the ingredients of section 151. That problem is also there. So that should not become a passion, no doubt. If necessary, they have to be called. Of course, in that case, it is necessary because they have given 151 notice. That's a different thing. Anyway, let us not dwell into the repeat. That is one such example. In recently in AP High Court, in so many Telangana High Court also, the government officers are being called. So please remember, government officers, definitely they have got their own priorities. As in the early part of the video, I told you that they have got so many priorities, they have to attend so many functions, they have to attend so many meetings. So cancelling all of them, they come to the court. So you may be knowing, when once you go to the court, 10 to 5 p.m. is totally lost. You have to be attentive. You don't know when your case will be called. All these things, problems will happen. So very good judgment by the Supreme Court that unnecessarily the government officers, the public officers should not be called. So you can cite this whenever any public officer is called. Very good case. Please read it. So Grameena Pradhana, this case, once again reiterate. Pradhana UP Grameen Bank versus Sunil Kumar LL 21 and SC 575. Previous case, that is State of UP versus Manoj Kumar Sharma, LL 2021, SSC 289. If you remember the two cases, you will be very clear. Thank you very much.